All right, let's get going. So here's my setup real quick. I'm wearing a chest harness and using my iPhone to record the video. So I'm trying out this chest harness for that. I'm hoping it will look all right on YouTube. So there's my easel. And then here's my new pastels. So we're gonna start with those, and then after we do the new pastels, then we're gonna get going with the oil pastels. All right, but first, let's take a look at the photo here that I am going to be painting from. I'm gonna be using this as my reference. And this is a photo that I took out of a couple weekends ago from Rockaway Beach in Oregon. So it's about central Oregon coast area, a little bit north of Tillamook. This light here, the sunlight coming through the clouds, I like how it's filtering through and how the light disperses out through the scene. You can almost see these sun rays. They're kind of coming out. I am using pastel matte. So this is a Clairefontaine pastel matte. Dimensions are 12 by 15 and a half inches, so I just pretty much say 12 by 16 inches. It's not quite that, it's more like 11 and a half by 15 inches maybe. And I like the white, and these come in different colors. You can get tone paper if you want, you can get different types of colors. Hard pastel, so these aren't oils. And the reason why I like to use new pastels to begin with is because they're inexpensive. It's easy to cover the paper, and you'll see that as I begin here, how easy it is to get coverage. And I like the variety of colors that they have, especially in the pinks and the yellows, kind of these warm colors here. And it's open stock. I can go to my local art store just a few miles away and I can buy these open stock. This is my first YouTube video ever done, so I'm sure when I watch this later, I'm gonna be shaking my head as far as, oh, I could have done so much better, but that's okay, gotta start somewhere. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put in this water line right here. You can see the water lines towards the top of the picture, and I'm gonna choose a gray to start off with. I'm gonna choose this gray right here. My first thing I'm going to do is define where that water line is. So it's about, you know, if I were to break it into thirds, right? So about one third down from the top is where it starts. So if I go to my paper here, if I find the halfway mark, that's about right here. Okay, so if I take a little bit higher, maybe that's about a third. Roughly, gonna be where that water line is going to be. And it's not perfectly flat. You can see it's kind of bowing up here in the middle. So it's about a stick down here and about, see, I got to raise it up on this side. So I need to raise it up about right there. You can see how I'm measuring it. So it's a full stick from the edge to where that water line hits. There we go. Okay. That's roughly where we're gonna go. Let me just get that gray in there. And I'm just using my fingers here to kind of rub that into the paper. You can see how easy this is just to get pigment down. Okay, so I got my gray here. Oh, this medium blue here. Sorry, I don't have names of my colors. I just go by medium blue, dark blue, light blue, medium gray. It's kind of how I do everything. And I'm just gonna put a bit of this blue right on top of that gray. And then looking at my photo here, we can start putting some of these clouds. And I'm going to go with a little bit lighter gray. So I'm not going to use this dark gray up in the sky. I'm going to use a lighter gray. That my clouds are gonna kind of come here. There's gonna be a lot of light in here, so I'm not gonna cover that with the gray. I'm gonna leave the white of the paper showing there. And the clouds kind of come up. Something like this. Bring that light gray into the water. And we're going to continue covering the entire surface with this light gray. Okay. So we got our water and we got gray all over everything else. Now, let's kind of do a little bit more definition as far as where the actual shoreline is going to be. We know it's going to be at an angle, right? We can see this angle here going. So I kind of want to follow that same principle. So I'm going to take this gray again. This is the darker gray that I started off up here. Now we're going to go into a brown, and this is a, not a dark brown, it's just a regular medium kind of brown. And then we're going to bring that back into the shoreline. So I'm going to go over the gray here with that brown, just kind of indicate kind of the edge of the water here as it meets the sand, right? Oops. I drop these a lot because they're so skinny that sometimes I lose grip of them and they fall. The cool thing is having this kind of easel, that this lip will grab it so it doesn't go all the way to the ground. Because if I drop these on the floor, they'll shatter. They're really delicate. All right. So I got the brown there. in my foreground here, look, you see it, there's a lot of green bushes and grass and shrubbery and, you know, just stuff down here. So I'm going to take this dark green and we're just going and I'm just gonna see if I can lighten up the sand a little bit. So I'm gonna try this yellow over it and just see what the pale yellow on top of that brown looks like. Now this is a really strong yellow. Whereas this one was a very pale yellow. So I would take this pale yellow and I did that there. And now I'm gonna try this very strong yellow. Come back with the light yellow again. Come back with the brown. So we're starting to get that sand color, right? Okay, so now I'm going to take a darker brown. This is my darkest brown. And I'm going to define a little bit more between where the shrub, the green shrubbery grass stuff starts and where the sand starts. So I'm going to You can see how these new pastels, how fast it is for me to just cover the paper and get the sketch going and work out these initial details and blocking out the paper. And that's why I love using them. So I'm gonna bring some of more of this brown right here, right where kind of the wet sand meets the dry sand, right? I'm just gonna make a little bit of mark here, some lines that are going across before I get into the water, just to define an edge of where that water is or where it starts. And maybe I don't want a perfect line going across like this. Maybe I wanna kind of vary it a little bit. I think it's more interesting when shoreline kind of weaves in and out. It's not a perfect line. I think it's more interesting. All right, we got a piece of driftwood out here, so I'm gonna maybe put that in there. Maybe it goes like that. Kind of indication of some driftwood. Maybe I'll put some more of those in there. I don't know. I'm gonna change that from the picture a little bit. Green here that I put down in here, and I'm gonna bring it up to this part of the water. And you might not be able to see it, but right here, the water has a nice, kind of a deep bluish, greenish gray color. And then we'll take a blue. We'll go right over the top. You can see I'm already starting to create indication of some waves. And I'm doing that just by dragging it horizontal. More of this green. A little bit more of that dark gray, which is right here. So yeah, so I used this dark gray and I used a blue, medium blue, and this dark green, and these three colors here all blended into right here. Okay. Now let's get a little bit more definition into the clouds. So if you look at my clouds here, you can see we have dark parts of the clouds, we have some lighter parts, we have some light coming through over here, and of course we have very strong light right here. So let's try to get some of that up here. So I'm going to get my darker gray right here. I'm going to define where the bottom of that kind of that big cloud there, big dark cloud that's right here. Kind of get the base of that in there, and that dark cloud kind of comes up here and it goes a little bit back there, back in there. Just kind of feathering that out a little right there. Maybe a little bit of dark here. There's like another little cloud that's right there. It's a little dark. And a little bit over there. And then kind of down at the base just a little. All right. And let's kind of rub that in. It doesn't change a lot when I rub it in. What I'm doing is I'm just kind of pushing that into the paper a little bit so it's not so loose. All right. Now let's bring a little blue to this, to these clouds, because there is blue there. So I'm gonna start with this, I like to call it sky blue. It's just a light. It's just a light blue, but I think it's referred to mostly as a sky blue. That's gonna come up here. So I definitely see the blue in these clouds. So a little bit on the horizon. Mostly it's kind of up in this area. And then I do see some sky that's actually coming through, actual blue part of the sky. So we'll put that in there, kind of on this side, as you can see, a little blue sky right here. So we'll put that up there. Okay, notice I left this white. That's where my light's gonna be. And it might all change. Actually might make this a little bit more cloudy, but for right now, that's where my light's gonna be. I'm gonna bring a little bit more dark base to these clouds. I'm gonna use this darker blue. And bring that into this area. There's a really, of course, this time of the year, the Oregon coast, it's just very cloudy and stormy and windy, and I like it. I like that kind of weather. makes things more interesting. As long as I'm, you know, not in danger, right? It's fun to enjoy a good windstorm or something. Okay. And I like this dark blue. I think I'm gonna bring some of that into the water, because when I look at that water, I can see a nice deep color right here. So I'm gonna bring some of this blue over to this water. Give me some more contrast, which is always pleasing. Trying to define some of these ways here. So I'm putting a little bit more pressure down to get a deeper contrast. As we're pretending we got some waves coming here. This blue is a nice dark value. I'm kind of going over some of these dark areas with it, make it even a little bit darker. So I'm not using oil pastels yet. This is all just this sketch. And for this exercise, I'm spending a lot of time on the sketch. Normally I will whip right through this, but I'm enjoying what's happening here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just keep using these new pastels for a little while. Make this foreground a little bit darker. And just rub that around a little bit. Okay, now let's work on this light. So my hands are pretty dirty. And I'm about to touch a light area with dirty hands. So let's clean the hands first. I like to use these wipes for that, these disinfecting wipes. It's real fast to just get the hands clean. I go through so many of those wipes. Just make sure I don't have any blue or any other dark colors on my fingers. All right, so I'm gonna take this very light pale yellow that I kind of used in the sand right here, and we're going to go up to the top where the sun's coming. And we're just going to get that yellow in. And I'm not being detailed, trying not to be detailed. Just want to cover that white with the yellow. And if I look at my photo, you can see the light comes down and it comes across like this, kind of peeks through the clouds here. And there's some other kind of lighted clouds over here. I have to find an edge of one of these clouds with that white. Or not white, the yellow. And then over here, we have that light also kind of peeking through a little bit over here. This is that nice pale yellow. And it's doing a good job acting as my sun for right now. Lighten those a little bit. Okay. Now, I'm not copying my photo exactly, right? I don't really like to copy photos exactly. I like to pull out a few things, like where I'm really focusing on the light. But how the light rays look, I'm not gonna copy. All right. Back up a little bit, might be easier to see that. And I'm gonna bring some of these light rays, because I noticed that you can actually see kind of sun rays kind of coming down. I'm just gonna kind of loosely just kind of put those in there. And then of course where that sun hits that water line is really bright. So we're gonna put in that light reflection off the surface of the water. Let's make sure my line is straight. And then we're gonna keep going. But I'm gonna bring in this yellow. So that was a light yellow right there. And then of course a darker yellow. And I'm gonna continue the light. Oh, it's turning a little green. So let's bring this light yellow back, which doesn't turn green. And we're just gonna kind of indicate how that light comes through the scene. I'm using horizontal marks here. Right, and it's really bright here, right where that wet sand is. It's getting really bright. And even into the sand itself. That light is, strong, to say the least, right? So let's really emphasize it. Okay. So let's take a look at this. Let's back up and look at it. All right, so this is a great start. I've got the elements here that I was wanting to get. I've covered the paper. I figured out my composition as far as how my water line is gonna go, where my light is, how my clouds are. One more little thing I'm gonna do is bring a little highlight to the top of the driftwood. And it just kind of helped me define an edge there, a little bit more contrast. Find a bottom part to it. Okay. All right, so this is stage one. This is my sketch, my composition. My underpainting is another term for it. And I use these new pastels to do that with. So here's my grays. I didn't actually ever use the white. I used that brown, I used the medium dark brown. Didn't even get into my pinks. And I've got a few blues and a green. So far that's what I've used. And just out of curiosity's sake, let's see what happens when I put a little pink up in the clouds, which is always interesting, even though I don't really see a lot of pink in the photo. I like pink to really warm up objects that are getting hit by the sun. Okay. Alright, so let's take this back down a little bit. So I'm not so close to the light, my light source. My water line is not perfect right now. I can see it slanting a little bit, but it's close enough. It's close enough that I can fix it with the oil pastels. So, okay, so that is stage one. That is layer number one, is the sketch, and I'm using new pastels. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this outside, and I'm going to use this workable fixative. It's made by Krylon. And I got this at my art store. It's about $9 for this can. This is toxic, so do not spray this indoors. Outside's best, and make sure that when you're spraying it, you're not spraying it on your clothing by mistake, that the spray is moving away from you. Obviously, you don't want to breathe this stuff in. But I think any workable fixative would work for what I'm about to do. So I'm going to take this outside, and I'm going to spray the entire surface with this Krylon workable fixative. I used other brands. I used a Grumbacher, which was fine. The Sennelier is fine. It's just expensive. This works just fine, and it protects pencil, pastel, and chalk drawings. This is pastel. This is perfect. It's acid-free, archival safe. I find that the Krylon, this particular brand, the mist that comes out of this aerosol can is really fine. So it's not goopy, you know. It's a nice, fine spray. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Spray that fixative over it. And now you can see what it looks like. Anytime you spray fixative over pastel, it darkens everything. So everything gets darker, which is fine. I don't care because I'm going to go layers. I'm going to start now going with oil pastel, and I'll do layers and layers of that. So I'm not caring what this looks like right now. But if I was a pastel artist, I probably would never use fixative, and I would just frame everything under glass just for what fixative does to pastels. But it's a separate conversation. So here we have my sketch now. I spray that fixative over it. So when I rub my fingers across, I'm not getting any pigment come up. I did a really good coverage here. And even if I did this and I got a little bit, that's okay. It's not going to ruin anything. But I got really good coverage. You can see I can rub my light and nothing's coming out, maybe a little bit. And also what the fixative also does is it adds some more texture to the surface. So now the surface is a little bit more gritty. It's a little bit more coarse, I guess. Kind of feels a little bit more like sandpaper. And that's really helpful for oil pastels to get layers. I like to work off an easel, and I like standing while I work. Some people like to sit, no problem. I'll sit sometimes, but I do like to stand because I like to move around. Get that on there. Okay, now let's get to the oil pastels. So I need to pull out some colors that I'm going to be using. So here's my oil pastel palette, my full palette, and we'll talk about this a little bit. So I use three different brands of oil pastel. I use Sennelier, which is these. You're very familiar with Sennelier. The softest oil pastel that is out there. They're premium. They're, in my opinion, the best. And I do have a bunch of those in here. So I'd like to use Sens. And then Mungios. Now the Mungios, I pull the papers off, but this is a Mungio stick. And this is Mungio, let's see, it's called Mungio Gallery Artist Soft Oil Pastels. Because I think Mungio, they make different types of oil pastels. I think they make a student grade, and then they made something called an artist grade, and that's what this is. And then the next brand I have is Neo Pastel. Let me see if I can find, this is a Neo Pastel. So this is a Neo Pastel. And the Neo Pastel and the Mungio are very similar as far as their hardness goes. I find that they're very close and the colors are close. The the Neo Pastels are just a little bit skinnier. Here's a white Neo Pastel. And you can see next to the Mungio, the difference in size. Actually, here's a better example of a Neo Pastel that hasn't been used. So there's the Neo Pastel, there's the Mungio. You can see that the Mungio is slightly bigger stick. It's a little bit fatter. All right. So these are the oil pastels that I use. You can see I kind of break them out by color rather than brand. I kind of mix all the brands together because I know which ones are Sens, I know which ones are Mungios. So yeah, this is my palette. This is my working palette. This is what I do all my work with. I have a lot of grays. So I have this white, that's a Neo Pastel white, silver gray is right here. I use that quite a bit. And then I have these lighter grays. I have a new one called khaki gray. I like to call it khaki gray because it reminds me of those khaki pants. That's a Neo Pastel. Here's another Neo Pastel. It's another khaki gray color. And different grays, darker grays, green grays, black. I hardly ever use black. Not on landscapes. I'll use black in like maybe an animal portrait or just regular portraits. But on landscapes, I think it's too strong. So yeah, I recommend you have a good selection of grays. I recommend that you get warm grays, cool grays, green grays, blue grays. Get yourself a nice variety of grays. You're gonna use it. And I have a few Grand Sennelier. So this is a Grand White Sennelier. This is the whitest white that you can get for an oil pastel. There's nothing that will lay down whiter than this Sen White. The next closest thing is this Neo Pastel White. But the Sen White's the best. And then I have a dark blue. This is my darkest color that I'll use. I like to use this instead of black. And it's actually a blue Sen, a dark blue Sen. And so I have that there. And then this is probably the most important one I have. It's this oil pastel colorless blender that's made by Sennelier. This is the Grand Stick. And this is basic medium. This is really what it is. It's medium. It's just like an oil painting if you had liquid or some kind of solvent or something to spread the paint across. That's basically what this is, and I use it quite a bit, and I'll explain this a lot in detail on how I use it. But I have a grand one of those, and then I have some backups, regular size, and Sennelier makes this, and it's just an oil pastel stick, so it's just oil and wax, and there's no color. They call it a blender. To me, it's just medium. And it comes in very useful, and I'll show that a little bit more in detail here. So, this is my palette. So I'm going to pull some color off. I know I'm gonna use this, that's obvious. Let's look here, what other colors am I gonna use? Well, we know we're gonna use gray. So we're gonna pull off kind of a dark gray, put that there. This is a Mungio that I haven't removed the papers off yet. This is kind of a medium, just a regular medium gray. So we've got a dark gray, a medium gray. This khaki gray is nice for sand. I like it for sand and other uses, but we'll definitely use that. And we have a nice kind of a light blue gray. It's got some blue tint to it. I like that for clouds and sky. So that's kind of a light blue gray. And then even a lighter gray that has a little bit blue in it is there. And then the silver gray, which is my warm gray. It kind of leans to the warm side. And I think this and this are the same. Yeah. Okay. There's some grays. I'm not going to pull a green gray out quite yet. So there are some grays. And of course, I'm going to use a lot of gray in the clouds here. And then I like to pull a blue out. Now, these are sapphire or Prussian blues. They're very similar. But when you mix the blues in with the grays, you can kind of get that perfect value that you might be looking for. So I got that there. Let's see, what else? Let's go with a pale yellow. I'm going to use that for our light. That along with the silver gray and the white should give us a nice light. I am going to pull some of this salmon pinky color out. Maybe a couple other pinks. Even though there's not pink in the reference photo. Can't really see pink, but I don't know. I like the pink-yellow combination, especially in sunsets. And okay, let's get some light blue. Get some blues. We're gonna use this for some reflection of the wet sand. Brown. Pretty much always use a brown. Here's an ochre. And then a little bit darker ochre. So I got a couple different ochres, a light ochre, medium ochre, I guess. It's kind of part of the yellows over here. So I'm just kind of pulling colors I know I'm going to use, right? And I might pull some more out later, but I know I'm pretty much going to use most of that in there, if not all of it. And definitely green. And which green, right? That's always a struggle, is what green am I going to use? So let's pull out a green gray. Green gray. And then let's see what other kind of greens I got. Maybe this kind of a pine green, kind of a warm pine green. Maybe, we'll see. This is more of a, it's got more blue in it, that's for sure. More of a pure green, but, and greens are really strong color. I'm not sure if I'm gonna use that, we'll find out. Yeah, maybe a dark, I'm gonna bring out my dark blue. This is my dark value here. I also got this big one here, but sometimes it's easier to do with the little stick. Okay, I think we're gonna start with this. And I'm gonna start up in the clouds. I basically like to work top down. And I think it has a lot to do with how I draw, because how I draw, it's like this, and so where my hand rests on the paper, if I start down here and move up, I'm gonna mess up these parts in here. So I like to start at the top, and I see some blue up there, so I'm gonna start off with some blue right up here. So first thing I'm going to do before I do that is I'm gonna take my colorless oil blender stick by Sennelier. All right, and I'm going to take that and just rub it right on the paper, right where I'm gonna be working. Now, sometimes I'll do the whole thing. Sometimes I'll just do the part that I'm working on, and that's kind of what I've been doing lately, is I don't cover the whole thing. I just cover the part that I know I'm going to be working on. And I just do a few passes. And I'm not pressing in. I'm just kind of letting the paper grab it. And what ends up happening is you start to feel the oily, waxy feel on the surface. It's kind of a sticky, oily, waxy feel. And when I feel that, that's when I know I have enough on there. So right now, everything's a feel game right here. So I think that's pretty good. I can still feel the grit, but I can feel that oily, sticky from here. This is gonna allow me to move the color easily. All right, so spread that on there. And then we're gonna take a little blue. We're gonna start up here with this little bit of blue. Now this is a Neo Pastel medium blue. You can see the value of it there. It's kind of a strong, bright blue color. I'm just taking that, because in my reference picture, I see that this area has got some blue in it. So we're gonna put some blue in there. And maybe kind of back in here, there's a little bit of blue. And even over here, I see a little blue. And of course we have the sky poking through, so I'm gonna use my sky blue color for the sky part. So I use this medium blue to kind of put over here. Now I'm gonna go with a lighter blue and actually put in where I actually see sky. And it's right up in this corner. So I'm gonna kind of get some sky color in there. And that nice medium blue will come back a little bit more over it. Okay. And then we got a gray, because most of it is gray. Right? You know, you see some blues here, but that's a strong blue. So we're going to take this gray and we're going to go over the top. It's kind of a dark. I wouldn't say it's a dark gray. It's looking dark, but it's actually medium. It's more of a medium gray. And that's gonna go right in here. So I'm not using a lot of pressure when I do this. not right here. It's more just letting the paper kind of pull the pigment off the oil pastel stick. And just kind of scrubbing it. And we have some of that cloud comes in here. We have some dark cloud area down in here. And then a little here. Okay. And then this is a lighter gray. This is a, it's got a lot of blue in it actually, but it's a nice light gray. That's gonna go in here as well. But I gotta let some of that dark in, right? So we can't rub this all over the whole thing. Just kind of where the light is able to penetrate through the clouds a little bit easier is where I'm going to be using this lighter gray. Maybe actually down here, as the sky meets the water definitely lightens up in this particular picture. So I'm gonna go ahead and kind of help define the sky and the water line by just kind of taking this gray, this light gray here, and kind of slowly create a horizon here with that. Just making sure that it's straight across as best that I can get it. And we're gonna continue that right on through the entire horizon. Less so over here, more so over here. The reason why it's less so over here, because I already have a strong light source that I'm gonna be using. Always mindful of my light and its effect, even at the very early stages. I'm gonna use my finger and kind of soften that edge. This is a part of the painting that's far away from the viewer, so we don't want any hard edges here. We don't want hard lines. We want nice soft lines, soft edges. I just take my finger and I just kind of smudging kind of the gray and then this light gray, and kind of together creates a nice soft edge here. Take a look at that water line and see if it's relatively flat, right? It's not coming up too much. Maybe a little over here, it's kind of coming up. But overall, it looks pretty good. Maybe a little bit more over here. I need to just soften this edge right here. Just soften that edge. Nice. All right. Let's keep going with this light gray color. I'm kind of looking at my reference picture while I kind of mark in where I see this gray. Indication of where some light's going to be happening. I'm coming in with that darker gray again, that my medium dark gray, and go over again. So you can see, like, I'm just kind of laying colors into the paper. I just go slow. I'm just not really worried about actual strong details. It's more just kind of, oh, I see this part's dark, so I'm gonna put some dark there. You know, that's kind of how I'm doing it. There we go. Kind of break up that a little bit. I don't want a line going across here. Okay. So just really loose cloud work. Now we're gonna take a stump. I got lots of stumps here. Let's get some of these out. These are all old. I need some new stumps. That's definitely, we'll go if we use that one. Okay, let's grab one of these. Okay, so these are stumps. You can find them at your art store. You can find them on Amazon. They're easy to find. These are large stumps, and I have different sizes here, even down to these small blending tortillons here, which is basically a smaller stump. But I like these big guys because they're just easier to hold on to for me. And they're nice to blend with. So I'm taking this stump and I'm just doing this kind of circular motion up here in my sky. And I'm taking all those values that I put down earlier, the blues, the two different grays I had, and I am just kind of blending everything together. And trying to make sure that I get good coverage on this paper and that I'm covering over that first layer with this oil pastel. So I go from the stump, and I'll use my fingers a little bit. Go back to the stump. Make sure my camera here is picking up everything. I always have to be mindful of making sure you guys can see what I'm doing. That's the whole point of this, right? This is just a nice, easy blending. I'll use my fingers, it really helps. Then I'll come back to the stump. My fingers. And blending. Blending, we do a lot of blending in oil pastel, at least I do, the way I'm using it right here. For this particular look here, just try to spread that color out. And it's okay when the colors go into each other, that's totally fine at this stage. Keep going. We got some of that gray over here. This is why, when it comes to papers, I'm really picky on the surface I use, because after doing this for a while with your fingers, and you want something nice and soft. After a while, if you use the really coarse surface and you're using this kind of style, your fingers are going to start to feel raw and it's not enjoyable. So this pastel mat, that's why I like it a lot, because it's just, it doesn't irritate me when I'm blending with my fingers. Careful not to bring my dirty hands over the yellow here. But I'm gonna bring some of that on the edges there. Right? All right, let's keep going. I want a little bit darker over here. So I'm gonna take this medium gray, kind of a dark medium gray. We're gonna do a little bit more coverage. So this is now the second layer of oil pastel in the clouds. And I am kind of reinforcing the dark part of the cloud, which is kind of towards this bottom edge here. Fading that out. And there's a little bit of light that comes through this part, and then it's dark again. And we got a little bit of blue, just a little, and then we're dark again here. So I'm kind of looking at my reference picture and I'm just kind of picking out, okay, where's the dark parts of the clouds? Well, that's what I'm getting in right now, so like kind of the darker parts. So we're just gonna go ahead and keep going with this gray. And the dark part of it kind of comes down into here. Now I'm starting to do more of a circular, kind of like tops of the clouds, right? Like right there. I can still see a little bit of that pink from that new pastel underneath, which is cool. Kind of like in the way that looks. It definitely lightens up my cloud up here to this nice warmer value that's next to the sun. So it looks really good there. And then there's a little bit of dark gray in there. It's kind of dark right in there too. Now when you're doing this at home, this is all, you know, I'm kind of just winging it, right? Right? And it's not exact to my reference photo. And kind of where I'm putting these dark grays is, might be different than you, because, I don't know, we're all different. We're all different, so. And also the brand and the surface makes a huge difference as far as what you're able to do with it. If I were to try a different paper, I might have a different, slightly different look. The surface of the paper really matters when it comes to pastels and oil pastels. Okay, so I got this nice gray that's got these hints of blue that are kind of peeking through. There's some parts of the cloud where I'll put in an edge and I'll press into the paper a little bit more to kind of bring more pigment down to make that value a little darker. There we go. Kind of make it look like, oh yeah, there's like a dark part of the cloud right here. Okay. Use your artistic license, right? I mean, that's the key here. Get lost in your work, right? There's another one. All I'm doing is I'm just taking that gray and I'm kind of defining a couple edges, mixing with the blue. Okay, let's look at that for a sec. Not bad, right? It looks, it's starting to look like a cloudy sky. Okay. As that gets a little lower to the horizon, I'm gonna lighten that a little bit. So let's take some of that light gray that we used down here, and I'm just gonna bring it up maybe a little bit more. Kind of feather it up. Just kind of feather that out a little bit more. There we go. Kind of cuts into the gray a little. And then I'm gonna bring it into this area right here, where this kind of gray, dark part of the cup kind of lightens a little bit. And you can kind of see the light filtering through over on this side. It's got to be random. Try not to make too many hard edges here. A couple are okay. There we go. Like a little light's just kind of filtering through, maybe a little bit more. It's kind of coming in right about here. Use my finger to kind of scratch that out a little. Kind of blend it in. Blending always changes the value of the color. So when I put it down, it's really strong. I'm gonna take my finger over it. I can change the value of that. Kind of fade it just to the right brightness. All right. And we're gonna keep going. So the cloud, you see a little blue sky right up here. I think the cloud, a little bit of light comes right here. A little bit of light peeking through here. I'm getting a lot more detailed here in the sky. Bring a little bit more blue. Careful. Blue is really strong, so. All right. Now let's go over here. So there's my picture. You can kind of see what I was doing to see the light coming through, right? Trying to create that same effect here. All right, now I'm gonna work on, take this pale yellow, kind of hit the light area with it. The light kind of cracks right through the clouds. And of course it's super bright here. And reinforcing my light. Thank you. This is always favorite parts of my painting, is when I get to light. You can really just have fun with this. So I'm just hitting pale yellow, the edges here of that gray. I notice that here, you can kind of see the edge of the cloud from that light. It's really strong. So this is a Mungio pale yellow that I'm using. And we're just playing with some light. And hear how the light hits that part of the cloud. Kind of filters. There's a little another kind of light coming through. Okay. I'm gonna take some of this yellow over this little light area, not a lot though, but a little, just a little. This is where you got to be an artist, and you just have to, you know, just think, I want more light here. It's not really about copying the picture. It's kind of getting an idea. The picture kind of gives you an idea. Maybe there's a few things you want to get just like your photo. But at some point, you just got to let the artist in you just come out and just make a scene up, right? And it just comes with practice. So the more you do this, the more you see things differently a little bit. The more confidence you get, the more you're able to just relax and not drive yourself crazy with trying to copy a photo exactly like you see it. What's more important is making sure the colors and the values are right. So I love a dramatic light, don't you guys? It's pretty awesome. All right, let's keep going with this yellow here. So kind of up in the top left corner, I'm gonna kind of outline some more clouds, another cloud right here. And right in there. There we go. All right. So that's good. I don't want to overdo that right now. I think it looks awesome. I could probably stop in this area and just be done. But now we're going to take a stump, and I'm just going to kind of go underneath where the light in the dark part of that cloud, and I'm going to soften that part. So this is the very light part, and there's the dark part, and between that, right in here, you want to soften this edge. Here I'm not even looking at my reference photo. I'm kind of just going, winging it. It's kind of, just softening these colors when they touch each other in between. All right. Let's take a look there. So that is that pale yellow. I got a medium kind of dark gray, a lighter gray. You can see a little pink in there from the new pastel. That's a couple layers down. And then a little bit of sky blue coming through. Yeah, it looks nice. Like I don't want to touch that area now, right? It's like I got it perfect. But we are going to touch it because I want to kind of define the bottom part of this sky a little bit more clear. I'm trying to figure out what color am I going to use for that. And when I look at my reference picture, oh, it might be a little lavender. Let's try the lavender. Let's try this. This is a Mungio. And I have to be careful with the blues sometimes. I know this blue is going to be kind of strong. So, but I'm going to put it kind of right at this bottom part of the horizon. And over here, yeah, I'll put it over here too. It's a nice compliment, that lavender blue and that pale yellow. That's a nice combination to have next to each other like that. Let's just see what that looks like. We're gonna do the whole bottom part there, that lavender. Okay. Now let's take a stump. Let's grab a different one. And we're gonna kind of spread that out a little. My stump has a different color on it. It's got some dark blue from a previous painting. So I'm actually laying a little bit of a dark blue when I do this, where my stump is hitting the paper, which is okay. I'm actually liking what it's doing. It's kind of creating that horizon for me. And we're just a little bit of that lavender in there. Okay. Nice. That lavender actually looks pretty good. Okay, so this is a light ochre. So before I was using this pale yellow up here. Okay. Pale yellow. Now I'm going to bring in a darker yellow, which is basically a light ochre. You can see the difference. It's kind of orangey. You can see the difference in these two yellows here. And I'm going to bring this up into the sky as well. So let's play with light. Let's play with light a little bit. So here's my light. Now, as the light goes further away from the source, so this is my source, the light changes color. And it gets a little bit weaker. And so I'm going to use this ochre to kind of suggest that we still have a little bit light here. It's just not as strong as that part. If you can understand what I mean by that. So a little bit of this ochre here changes changes the light. Gives us a different kind of dimension to the light. Okay, so underneath the clouds, right here, we have some light happening, and I'm going to use this ochre for that. Now, for those of you that are, maybe some of you watching this are trying to recreate kind of a similar painting to what I'm doing, you don't have to do this step using a different yellow here. I could have left it with this pale yellow and been, I think, would have been fine with that. But I know that I can do this and not create green. Creating some of the light as it filters through the clouds. It gets a little weaker down here. And even over here, the light's not as strong on this cloud. And even right here. Really light application, kind of a circular, you know, kind of smudging, circular, quick dabs to it. Bring it up to the edge of that cloud. There we go. Yeah. This part is not as strong here either. So there we go. Let's take a look at that. It's hard to see with this bright light in front of us, but hopefully you can see the difference in the yellows there. Okay. I'll take a stump here and we'll soften that part where the gray meets the bright light. Alright, coming along. Alright, I'm going to stay up in the clouds. I'm liking how everything is going. We're going to bring some pinks to further warm up the clouds. So this is a salmon pink, and it's salmon color. It's really what it is, that pink salmon warm color. This is a neo pastel, by the way. So right here, right where that light here comes, we're gonna lighten up that clouds. Drop a little bit of pink in there. Yeah, and maybe there's a cloud that actually is right in the light, you know? It's like sitting right smack dab in it. I'll break up that yellow a little bit. Then I'm going to take a torch, clean one, small. Very small, sharp, pointy edge allows me to get in there. And I'm just spreading that pink out a little bit. That pink in there. The pinks and the pale yellows and the ochres all working together. Taking this little tortillion here and I'm just kind of softening, blending colors into each other very carefully. There we go. Okay, so I like that pink up there, but I need to create a slightly deeper contrast with it. So maybe this lavender would help me with that. Maybe if I just put a little lavender on top of that pink. Create a little bit more contrast here as the light's coming through that. And then we're going to take a stump, which like this big one, and we're going to blend that into the pink and then the yellow. Just be careful not to make green. So I can kind of smudge over the top without really mixing in with the yellow. Before it turns green. All right. Spark it up a little. This is a different pink. So there's that salmon pink that I used earlier. This is a little bit cooler, a little bit more traditional pink. You can see the salmon pink here, and then this pink here. I'm gonna bring some pink to the clouds. A little bit more pink in there. Then I'm gonna bring a little bit of gray. Try to darken a little bit more, more contrast. I'm just kind of scrubbing that pink in there. And the gray. And we're gonna smooth it out here in a second. Okay, so here's a stump. Try to find a nice edge here. Right there. And we're just gonna blend that in very carefully, making sure I'm not getting rid of the yellows. It's more about dispersing the pink out. That pink really changes the game, you know? Kind of brings some warmth and it makes the light warmer, that's for sure. It warms up these clouds. And then up here, this dark kind of cloud that's kind of going over the light is gonna be lighter because it's directly in the sun, basically. And go to the top of that edge there. I'm using the edge of this pointy part of the stump and I'm kind of dragging the color across the clouds, you know? So, nice soft transition. And that pink really does warm things up. There we go. Really mix these colors here. And that gray and the pinks and even a little bit of that yellow's all kind of mixing right in there. Make sure I get up into the edges here. All right. Let's take it back. Take a few steps back and take a look there. So not bad, not bad at all. Okay, I'm gonna come back in with this pale yellow. I'm gonna redefine some of these edges of the clouds. get lost sometimes. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with how this area is shaping up. A little bit more that light ochre here to kind of flatten out the bottom part of that sky there. Okay. All right, let's go to a different part of the painting. I spent a lot of time up here, so let's kind of get some rest of this scene, get some water down in here, and then we can always go back, right? But that is looking pretty good. Nice dramatic light, which is exactly what I wanted. All right, so let's get down into the water. So we're gonna take that colorless sun oil pastel stick, and I'm just gonna lay some more oil down. I'm kind of working down. And it's the feel thing, you know. You'll after using this, you'll gain the experience. You'll know when there's enough. Sometimes I put too much on, and then it was then too oily to work with. I couldn't get any layers, so that happens. If that happens, you can do a few things to correct that. One, you can use a fixative. Just spray a fixative over it. Get some grit back. Another thing you can do is just let it set out for a few days. And if you have a nice, cool, dry environment, it'll actually harden up faster. You could even put it into your fridge or maybe even freezer for a little while to kind of cool it. When oil pastel cools, it tends to harden up. So I've done that before. I've actually put stuff in my fridge or my freezer just for a little bit, just to harden it up. If I'm having trouble getting layers, that's what I'll do. After a while though, after you get some experience, you'll know how to get layers without doing all that. But, just comes with doing more and more and more. You just kind of get used to the exact amount of this stuff to use. Okay, so spread that on there. It's got a nice oily little sticky feel to it. And we're gonna start defining this water a little bit better. So I know it's gonna be a combination of some blue, kind of this, kind of a Prussian or a sapphire blue, and then a gray. And then there's a slight bit of green to it. This particular water and off the Oregon coast has a little bit of green. So let's look at these three values here. So I got a gray, I got this Prussian blue or sapphire blue, and a kind of a green gray. And these are all, I believe these are all Moon Geo sticks. Right, so first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this blue and I'm gonna take an edge of it here, just kind of slowly, very carefully scrub that up the surface, just very light. Kind of kind of the deep part of the water, that ocean color water, which is kind of this deep bluish, greenish, kind of gray almost. Okay, now where the light hits it, I'm not gonna bring that blue here, but I will bring it over to the sides. The reason why I'm not gonna bring the blue here, because I don't wanna make yellow, or excuse me, I don't wanna make green when I start dropping these yellow marks here. So I know I need to stay away from blue right here. But where the light is not strong is where I'm gonna concentrate that blue. Maybe a little bit down to the shallower parts of the water. And a little bit over there, okay. Now we're gonna take the gray and we're gonna go right over the top of the blue. And same thing, we're just gonna lightly just cover it. Very light layer, not a lot of pressure. Same over here. All grays have some kind of blue in it. Most grays, I would say, have a combination of some blues. There is a little bit of blue in this gray, but not enough to produce a green. So I'm gonna put some of this gray in this part of the water. Cover that blue up a little bit there. Just get that gray down in there. There we go. Extend it out over here. Or maybe a little bit more of the blue. Kind of another layer of that blue. And then another layer of that gray. Not blending yet, I'm just kind of getting the color down. I want to be able to cover it, so I'm putting a few layers down. More of that blue. Every time I do this, I just drop more pigment down on the surface. I do it very carefully, very subtle. And each little pass, each little layer, just slowly builds up. Slowly builds up my image. Let's look at it. Nice. You see that it's definitely darker here than here. It's because of that blue. And we'll keep going. Notice the texture of the paper and what it's doing. It's basically creating waves for me, and I'm not even really trying to. I'm just really just dragging it across, and I'm letting the paper, I'm letting that grit, that surface, that oil that I put down, the fixative that's underneath it, and all the layers underneath, and I'm letting all that do the work for me. And all I'm doing is I'm just taking the stick, and I'm just dragging it. And it picks up and drops this broken color, this texture, and it really kind of already looks like waves. Right, so now we're gonna bring this gray over the top of that blue to kind of knock it back. I haven't blended yet, right? I'm just scrubbing colors on. So I haven't blended the water yet. You can see the texture there that I'm getting. All right. Now I want to bring a little green. but I'm not really sure if this green is too light. It might be too light. So let's just try it right here. Yeah, it's kind of light. It's lighter than that blue. You can see it's too light. So that green's not gonna really work out for me right here. I'm gonna need a darker green. Maybe this green. This green is kind of a blue green. It's a nice dark tint. Let's try a little bit of this right in here and let's just see what that color looks like. And it's a really strong value, that's for sure. So I'm not gonna press too hard on it. Let that paper do the work for me. And I'm kind of liking it. It's kind of working. I'm gonna bring it in a little bit into the light here. Kind of create a wave right here. And maybe there's one kind of right, see that highlight there? Right underneath the highlight, I can drop in this green, very loose, and create a wave. And extend that out a little bit more. And then maybe won't do that. Yeah, this green was a good choice. It's just a really strong green, so very careful with it. All right, so let's take that blue and we're gonna go over the top of the green a little bit. I'm gonna darken the wave here. Remember my light, right? So we're gonna have a nice contrast. We have a nice backlight. So we're gonna have some good contrast going right here because my light's really strong there. And we'll extend that blue out a little bit more. Essentially, indication of a wave. And we're gonna do a little blue over here. Right on top of that that green that we just laid down. And my application is light. Like I'm really not, this stage right here, I'm not putting pressure down. I'm just letting the paper kind of pick it up for me. Okay, so right where the water meets the sand, let's bring in this brown. This is a medium brown, nice medium, I guess a medium dark brown. It's one of my darker values, and this is a neo pastel stick, I believe. All right, and we're gonna define that edge right underneath the highlight. Right underneath the light part. Okay. That combination, that light, dark, right next to each other, it's very eye-catching. Definitely appeals to our right brain hemisphere. I'm gonna take more of that brown. And we're just slow, very carefully defining that edge. Maybe even up into the sand a little bit. You know, as the sand gets wet, it gets darker. I Let's bring that brown over here. Make that dark, wet sand over here. I have no oil here, and you can hear it's a little bit more scratchy. All right, we're gonna bring some of the brown up into the water and create some shallower waves right in here. If you notice, if you're looking at the beach, you're at the ocean, and you just watch the water, and you know that the shallow part of the ocean picks up a lot of sand, so you can see a lot of the brown, a lot of sand color into the water. That's kind of what I'm trying to recreate right there. This is the shallower part, so you're gonna see a lot more browns because you can see some of that sand get picked up into the water. All right. All right, so got the brown, got this blue. I want to drop a bigger wave back in here. And kind of see one here. So I'm going to take this blue and create a wave that's kind of lifting up, right? This is a bigger wave back here. And maybe there's another one that's kind of right in front of it a little bit. Okay, so you can see where the peak of the wave is going to be, right in there, and it kind of slowly tapers off. All right, and let's do another one right here, another line. This one's not going to be as big as this one. This one's bigger because it's just a little bit closer to us. This one here, it's the beginning of another wave as another swell comes through here. And some distant waves back in here. All right, notice my far water line where the water meets the sky. Notice there's no hard edges. There's really not an edge defined at all. It kind of just melts away into this gray before it gets to the light gray. So I don't want to create a dark line back there. I want that water to recede. I want it to feel like it's far away from us. If I put a dark line there, it immediately jumps forward. So just careful of that. I'm always thinking of things in space, you know, where it is dimension-wise, like in more of a three-dimensional sense, right? Because we live in a three-dimensional world, so I want to try to depict that when I paint. Think of things as three-dimensional. Drop a little bit of that blue on top of that brown, and it gets a slightly darker value. And I'm just slowly adjusting my values as I go through the painting. I haven't defined my darkest value yet. That's going to be in the foreground. But throughout the painting, it's a constant adjustment of values. And I use a lot of these blues and browns to kind of push that in either direction, plus some grays. You can lighten things up, obviously, with the grays. But it's really a value, a play on value of the color, the strength of the color, the darkness, the lightness of it. That's one of the most, probably the most important aspect of it besides composition and getting that sketch correct in the beginning. Okay, so I haven't blended. We haven't blended yet. Kind of just playing around. So you can see some waves are starting to happen. And if you notice, my waves aren't going parallel to each other. It's not like, because that wouldn't look normal. I want my water to look organic and real. And so you just vary up your wave lines. You know, you have some that are kind of coming up and some that are coming this way. So altogether, it looks a little bit more organic and real. Okay, so I like the way the water is looking. I'm going to go ahead and we're gonna go ahead and just do a little blending into it. And I wanna stay horizontal motion when I do this. Just cause I'm working on water and water needs to lay flat. So my marks, my strokes need to be flat. Don't wanna do this. Not on the water. And I'm just doing a light blend. So I'm not blending everything together. As you can see, I'm not doing this. I'm blending the blue and the green together. I'm keeping those marks where they are relatively to where I put them. And then the stump is just kind of pressing in, kind of dragging out, kind of smearing it up a little. I changed the value in some areas by doing this. Kind of want to disperse the green out a little bit more. Kind of smooth it out. It's not a hard blend. Some areas I'm not blending at all, I'll just leave. Some areas I'll hit. And this is all just judgment, man. It's just, you know, this is where when I got to thinking about doing videos and trying to teach, it's like, you know, some of it you just feel through it. Like there is no rhyme or reason. I'm doing things because over the years and experience, you just learn and it becomes second nature. So trying to teach that is not easy. Some things I do, I don't even really think about. It's just automatic. I'll switch between the stump and my finger, and it's just, sometimes I like the way the finger blends a little better in certain areas. And this is just one way of using oil pastels. You know, if you go out there on YouTube, even though there's not a lot of tutorials on oil pastel, but YouTube, Instagram, or Facebook, there's lots of different applications and techniques. This is just one of those ways of doing it. It's a layering process. I'm just building up the image as I go, as I keep dropping color and blending, and over time the image builds. All right, so I'm gonna kind of take that stump and going to over here. Smooth that out a little bit better over here. I really like the green over here because of the light kind of brings out the color of the water a little bit more. Make sure I get into my edges. Smooth it out. Really love this green right here. Really enjoying that color right there. Plus the gray makes it the perfect light. You know, that kind of that soft, subtle, soft light coming through. Okay, be careful back in here not to go too high. That's softer back in there. So use these stumps to really soften your edges. Create that sense of dimension, that three-dimensional feel. I want to feel like I'm standing here. All right. Just kind of working down. Let's take a look at that water. Nice. I'm really loving the color of that water. And we take a look up close to it, we can pick out those colors. So we got that green and then that blue kind of mixed in here. And then we have that medium to dark gray that's really all this. In between the green, you have this gray, right? And it's just warm enough so it feels like light. Right all the way down to here. And then we got that pale yellow to bring out some sun. We're hitting the surface of the water. And of course our clouds and our sky here. And then the near horizon back here. It's kind of bright. Let's smudge it a little bit, kind of darken it a little bit more. Yeah, there's that blue creating that nice wave for us. Soften that a little bit better. There we go. Take a look from about 6 feet away. Coming along good. All right. Let's keep going down. We'll go down into the sand. And I'm gonna pull out this color that I didn't have before, plus my khaki gray. Let's just see what this does. Here's getting a nice warm sand color. I need some oil. The surface is pretty dry right there, so I'm gonna have to scrub in the oil. Get a good layer of oil there. There we go. A little bit more down here. Okay. Now let's take some of that. This is really like a fleshy light pink, very peachy. And it's gonna be some of my sand color. I'm gonna put that down. Okay, I'm gonna take some of this, what I like to call khaki gray. You can see here, so this was, they're very similar, this one's just darker. So this is more of a gray tone. We're gonna put that over the top of that. And kinda adds a little bit more gray to it. Now my driftwood is here and it's kind of disappeared on me, so I'm gonna redefine it here in a second. Okay, now I got those values down. I'm actually gonna blend those guys pretty good. Okay, so you see I had blue on my finger, and when I rubbed it, I then put blue on the surface, but it's okay. I'll just rub it out. It happens sometimes. I don't realize my fingers have got colors on them. I accidentally put down a color I didn't want to. Some brown, kind of drop in my driftwood here, a piece of driftwood coming up here, maybe there's another little piece right there, just a piece of wood here. A lot of driftwood on the Oregon coast, tons of it. It's everywhere. Some places it really stacks up. All right, so I'm kind of creating with this brown, I'm kind of creating some dark parts. And this is kind of where we're gonna get into the grass area, but I see some dark little hills. So I'm coming in with this brown and I'm kind of defining those little spots. Okay. Some driftwood stuff. And then I'm going to take some gray. Very lightly go over some of this in gray. And I'm just doing that because my reference picture right in here, I see some gray. So that's what I'm putting right here. Kind of transitioning to the grass. I can use this gray right on this brown to define some more waves, kind of the shallowy waves. Those retreating waves, those small waves that kind of push back a little. Again, using my artistic license, I am trying to make indication of the smaller waves there. Thank you. Just a little front edge there. Nice. Huh? Nice. All right. Now, I'm going to just drop some waves in here, like real waves. Let's get some grays out. So this is my kind of a light gray that's, I used it in the sky earlier. It's got some blue in it. But it's gonna look like white when I drop it right on top of these, right on top of here, and I'll show you. So, right at the crest of this wave here, we have the wave itself, the breaking part of the wave. This is not white, and it looks like white against this blue and other grays, but it's not white, it's a light gray. So we have a little bit of breakage there. And then this area here is really choppy. This is where you get all that white water. And we got another wave here. I'm just gonna get in that gray, indicate, yeah, this is really where the waves are breaking. Got your dark areas and your light areas, so get that nice contrast going here. This is that shallow water, the kind where you go standing in it and you can watch your feet sink into the sand, right? I love doing that, by the way. You just go stand in that shallow water and then watch your feet sink into the sand. That's kind of this area right here. Keep going with the breaking waves, so right here. Right. And some back in the this part of it. There's another wave back here. Yeah. It's looking good. It's looking like the ocean. This part is real frothy, you know, that kind of that sea foamy, frothy, salty water. That texture of the paper is really helping me get that wave look. And if I put more pressure on the paper and get more pigment down, you can create a lighter gray rather than I just drag it across. But when I actually press into the paper, get more of that pigment in, you can create a stronger highlight. Okay, so I really like this here. And I like all that texture I'm creating. But as I get to the sun, I'm gonna have to change this up because this gray is cool. It leans blue, right? Well, it's not gonna really work back in here. I need a warmer value. On the sides, I can kind of do that. Right where that light highlight is, I gotta change it. So I'm gonna get up to that area and then I'm gonna switch my crayon out and my stick out. I like to call them crayons sometimes. So we're making movement, we're making the water move by doing this. The texture, making that water move, making it come alive. All right? It's always good to look at your work from a good 5 to 6 feet back every once in a while to kind of make sure you're on target. Okay, so this is a lavender. This was that light gray. Now back in the lavender, this will also look like a light value, but it's gonna be slightly different dark. Slightly darker, but I'm gonna put a little bit, just a little. Just a little back in there, that lavender. Just a little. Okay. All right. Now, this area. Probably gonna go with these ochres and yellows. I might even do some of this salmon color. Let's try the salmon color first since it's not as bright. Let's just see what that looks like here. It's like every time I do a, a beach or a scene like this, it's always different. I use different colors. I try different techniques a little bit. It's like no sunset beach is the same. This is a nice highlight here. We're just bringing that light. bringing that light down. I think it's really, man, it really reflects the sun, like right here. Like this whole area right here is just super, super bright. Even the sand here, wet sand here reflects that light too. Remember when I started off, I said that this part of the painting is going to be where I spend my most time. And that's exactly what's happening. Because to me, this area makes or breaks it. We're just going to warm this water up. I want to feel like I am standing here. All right, so if I take my finger across like that, changes the value just slightly. And if I don't do that, and it stays nice and bright. So that's how I'm able to disperse the values as I recede back, is I can use my fingers for that. A couple of bright marks where the wave catches the light just the right angle. Go. All right. Not too bad, right? So, let's extend the warmth out a little bit more, shall we? Well, maybe the light is catching this part of the wave just a little bit, bringing some little pinks in there. Now this little wave here, since it's catching a light, I'm going to drop in maybe a little bit of a lighter. Just a little. So that was like a sand turquoise, huh? Right there. Make it look like the light's kind of going through the water, through the wave there, right? Kind of lightens up that wave a little bit more. All right, now we're gonna keep going with the light here. So, got my yellow, my pale yellow. I use pale yellow a lot. It's a good highlight color. And this is a Mungio, and I'm just kind of cleaning it off. Got a little blue on my fingers here. Make sure I don't have other colors on there. So it's just yellow. And we're gonna drop strength of that light. The brightest part of that light coming straight, coming down. And back in here, just a little bit. Don't want it too bright back there. A little bit there. Just playing with the light as it comes through this area. Okay. Nice. It's got some nice color to it. This wave here, though, maybe I'll just kind of cool it off a little right there. Okay. Now I did a little bit of that turquoise here. Do I want to do any over here? Maybe. Let's see. Just a little. That was a sen. That's a sen. That's the first sen I've used. It's that turquoise sen right there. This guy right here. Let's get this nice turquoise green. As if the light is kind of dispersing through the water, it lightens up the water. And you can actually see some of that turquoise green color. It's a really pretty color. Light shines on things, it brings out the colors, right? Colors are more vibrant, more striking. Okay. You see that turquoise in there? All right, I'm gonna keep coming down. Take a little break though, so I'm gonna turn this off for a second. All right, this is that yolk ochre. I'm kind of bring that a little bit back in here. Actually, I'm going to do some of that ochre in the clouds, maybe. I don't know why I'm doing this. We'll find out, though. Yeah, right in here, it's a little bit different. spread that ochre out a little bit. It's a nice golden color there with the yellow, pale yellow. Kind of digging it. Let's try a little bit more. At the edges of that very pretty. I like that ochre there, actually. It's a little bit different than the pink. You can still see the pink. But the ochre is a nice, warm, golden feel. I'm using the opposite end of this tortillon because this one has a little bit of blue at the tip. I know if I take that blue here, it'll make green. So. Always make sure I'm not making green. Try not to make green where I don't want green. There we go. Kind of bring some warmth there to the clouds. Tip. Get that bright yellow. Bright yellow. I'm just going crazy with my sky, right? It's like, I didn't even intend to do all this, but I'm doing it for some reason. All right. And I think I'm gonna, this wave is so short that I think I wanna actually kind of bring it out a little bit more. Make it a little bit longer. Okay. Got that strong ochre up there. Make sure I don't have blue. Okay, just playing with the light. Now, let's get this lavender down in this part. Because this is going to reflect. This is that wet surf that reflects a lot of the sky. This part I am going to blend to try to get that shine over here too. Leave some of the brown showing, but some of this is going to be blended. Okay, let's take a stump and let's get that color blended in. I'm gonna have to do a little bit more. A little more right here. And then blend. Is that it? Blue is coming through right there, so we're just gonna keep going. I'm trying to get that sheen, you know, that water sheen, or whatever you call it. That's what I'm trying to get here. Yeah, was that the, so this is a light gray to indicate where that starts there. And some of that brown. Looks a lot better there, right? Kind of define that area a little bit better. subtle blend here. Just changes that a little bit. All right, just more details. Just get more details in. Okay, let's move down a little further. Start working on this piece of driftwood here. This is where I start getting to my darker values. So this is a my darkest blue that I have, and you can see when I rub it out, you can see how blue it really is. But when it's placed on top of a brown, it makes it really dark, almost to the point that it almost looks black, but it's not black. So it's one way of getting a nice dark value without using black, is to take that dark blue sen and put it on top of a brown, and you can get a nice deep color with that. This is my piece of driftwood here. I'm pretending it to be driftwood. Create a little highlight for it. Hopefully it'll look like driftwood. That's the key. Drop a little yellow ochre or something to give it a stronger highlight, maybe. Kind of press in there. Press the pigment down there. Let's see. I don't think I want to use. Trying to find the right highlight for this little piece of driftwood here. That's about right. Okay. Decent enough with the grass in there. We'll see what it looks like. All right, now let's get down here. Here, we're taking this blue and we're going all the way over. This is that Prussian blue. Okay, and we take brown. We need some oil. Nice and oily. Take my dark blue sun, create some dark areas. More contrast over here because of the light. These are my dark areas, my darkest darks, right here. Just random darks areas. Maybe it's mostly dark in the corner there. Kind of cover that out. A little bit of brown, more dark, and then a stump. I'm gonna try to cover a little bit better. Get that nice dark in there. This is the darkest part of the painting. This is where my darkest value will be. So everything from here has to play with that. My dark value wouldn't be back here. It's too far away. But in the foreground here, it's gonna work good. All right, so nice dark darks. All right, dark, 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 dark. Okay, now I'm gonna bring in this is a, kind of an ochre. It's got more yellow in it though, or maybe like a more greenish yellow. But let's make grass or something. There's like some bushes, some coastal shrubs. Grasses. And I'm going right above that dark, right where that dark, right above it. just get crazy with it. Just random little slashes, different parts. More color in some parts. Yeah, just kind of cut that in there. Cut into the dark a little. You can see it's getting all blue at the end there. And clean it off. What's the Levi example? Sorry. I am zoning out here a little bit. It's natural. It's supposed to happen. You're supposed to be zoning out while you paint. So I hope you guys are zoning out. That's the best part. It's supposed to be, there's an element in painting where you lose yourself, you zone out, you forget, you kind of just forget everything. And you catch yourself later on, you're like, ooh. That's the best part of painting. Is when you're painting along and, you know, you're trying to get colors down, you're trying to get something to look like something, and after a while, you lose yourself. This is giving me some good texture here with some grass. There we go. I'm just winging it. Okay, let's look at that for a sec. Pretty cool, huh? All right, now let's try this this green gray. I haven't used it yet. Let's put some of those in there. And that's an actual lighter value, see that? Lighter than that ochre was. Get some of that green in there. It's picking up that blue pretty good, so let's wipe that off. That yellow, that greens together, make some grass. Take some of that grass up into the driftwood there, kind of knock it down a little. This is a brown. Just kind of random marks there. Here's that yellow ochre that I was using up here. We're gonna bring some down here, but we're gonna clean it off a little bit. So I'm nearing the end. I am nearing the end. I am like 90% done with this painting, I think. Let's bring this lighter ochre. You can see you can really punch the light. Oops. Yeah. happens sometimes when they get too skinny, they break off. Let's get that light to really hit these grasses. Right? It's all about that light. Maybe it's, you know, it's just hitting the tops of these reeds here. Get the idea, right? Really bring in that light. And this is a different ochre, a little bit darker than the one we were just using, but I'm gonna use it over here. I like the gold it brings. I keep cleaning this off so I can get that ochre down. Let's come over here, let's bring a little warmth over here. You see all that there? A lot of texture going on in the foreground. All right. Now this pale yellow here that we use quite a bit. And it'll look quite a bit different down here, but if I can get some of that to lay down, which gets a few marks in there. Okay. Some blue. And you would think, why am I using blue? Well, it's a good contrast to the yellow. And maybe some of these reflect a little sky color, you know, which the sky is kind of blue. Kind of blue. And then that sand, I'm actually gonna bring up some of these areas. By doing this. khaki color. Khaki gray. I'm calling it khaki gray. Kind of extend the sand out a little bit more over here. Change the landscape up a little. Make it a little bit more interesting, I think. Pink. What do I do with pink? There we go. Pink. This is the part of the painting where there's just no rhyme or reason to anything I'm doing. it's just being, you know, just trying stuff. You know? I mean, I don't like to do things exact to pictures. Not even really looking at my reference anymore, just kind of thinking, I kind of want to break up the sand or the grass and get some sand in there. And like maybe down in here is like a little sandy part that we can just barely see. You know? There's no reason other than just to make it different. And some more brown to kind of break it up. Yeah, I think it's working. This is brown here, it's kind of breaking it up a little. Provides a little bit different value. A little bit of this sky blue. And those blues really help the yellows and the ochres really pop. That's the main reason why I'm doing that, but it's a good shadow indication too. Getting really thick down here. I'm not able to really get much more coverage. When I laid that dark blue sun down, it kind of prevented that. So I'm gonna take a plum here and I'm gonna warm up some of the darks on this side. And I've started using this plum, this they call it Bordeaux sen. It's like a violet, like a plum violet color, but on top of the blue, it warms up that dark to like a warm dark, which I'm enjoying using. Bring some of that kind of reddish, warm plum color down into this area, because that's where my light is. And it's just a nice color to just, it's very pleasing actually, just to use that a little bit. clean it, strike, rub it off, strike it. Try a different one. And try this little nub. Use the rest of that. There we go. Alright, let's drop a little bit of shadow for that driftwood here. So we're just going to darken this little area here. A little blue. Maybe we'll put a little brown in there. Maybe. We'll take a stump that has a lot of blue on it and just kind of rub that in there. Now the driftwood's kind of popping out of the grass. Okay. A lot of movement, right? A lot of action. I like that. No water right there. Okay, I'm gonna clean my hands. Get my hands clean. Clean this pink, get the blue off it, come back up here a little bit more with that pink. Almost slipped with that. Just gonna smooth this out a little more. Kind of like the pink and the ochre kind of on top or right next to each other. So I'm kind of done with this painting. What I'm doing now is I'm just playing around. Kind of just smoothing out these clouds a little. I want a little bit less and a little bit smoother. to change that blue too. If I take, so that was that sky blue. And if I take this silver, not a silver blue, but a light, my light blue that has a little bit of, my light gray that has a little blue in it, excuse me. I put it on top of this blue here and just slightly change that color blue. I like it up here, but down towards here, I need it to be a little lighter. Just kind of knocks it back a little, so it's not so, it's not such a vibrant blue. I think it'll look a little bit better, a little bit more natural, I think. Okay, now I gotta find a clean part of this stump. See if that'll work. Kind of wipe the blue off of it, there we go. And mix that in a little. It's a little bit natural, a little bit more natural looking blue. Okay, now I'm gonna see what happens when I put white right where that, right where this yellow is, and make that my brightest bright right here. Kind of filter it out a little. Let's just see if that makes me happy doing that. Kind of does make me happy. Let's tone it down a little bit with the yellow. Don't want it too white. Supposed to be a beach painting and it ends up being a painting about light. That's pretty much how most of my paintings go. The light's important, gotta get that in there. Ends up being a major component. Pretty sweet. Repeat some of that ochre down here. It's such a nice golden value. It looks really good with these greens, that turquoise right there. I'm so glad I put that turquoise right there. And it's just sparkling off that water. Just gotta let that light just sparkle, shine. Nice. We're doing the finishing touches, the fine touches, the finishing marks that kind of really sets up the painting. You know what I mean? Kind of fine-tuning it. Like, the painting was pretty much done. I'm kind of fine-tuning it right now. Or messing it up. That's pretty much how it is. It's either you fine-tune it or you overdo it and screw it up, which I've done. I've overdone it. Gotta find that balance of getting what you want, but not overdoing it. So I'm just coming back in here and just giving me some more warmth in the water. I'll use this gray over here to kind of disperse that light. Neutralize some of the blue a little. Nice. All right. What more can I do to this? I think I'm done. Let's see. Am I done? So what if I made little light rays come down? Just very subtle. You know what I mean? Like, not super noticeable, but that's a little strong. Let's take that lavender. There we go. Oops, made a little mark there. I'll just rub it out. It's easy to correct mistakes. But I do like that, kind of that. You know what I mean? Little light rays kind of coming through. Kind of just coming out. Very subtle, but it's there. Let's make sure this is not having any blue on it. It's pretty good. Thank you. There you go. I think I kind of want a little bit strong one right, kind of right here. Very light, and then it pops right here, like it literally strikes that surface right there. I knew I'd be spending a lot of time on this light. I knew when I took the picture that I would be. All right, y'all. I am done. I need to be done. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. Yeah. Wait a sec. I'm done. I'm just gonna bring a little bit more of this ochre right here. Just kind of warm up that area. Sand where that sun kind of really hits against. Yeah, I like that right there. And you got these cool lavenders on the side. That golden ochre right next to it, really pretty. Okay, I'm done. I'm gonna stop. I am done. So, what do y'all think? Let's do this. Let's bring it down from the light source a little bit. It's not so bright. See a little better. Yeah, so I remember when I took this picture, it was about 4 o'clock. It was right where the sun hasn't really entered sunset. It's kind of, you know, hasn't gotten to the horizon yet, but it's just right above, right in those clouds. And I remember taking the pic, trying to capture that. You can see how I made the light just really shine it up. And then as we get away from the light, things cool off. Got some different kinds of textures going on in the foreground. Grasses, some driftwood logs. All the grass textures, different kinds of colors in there. You can see it. See the little sun rays I made? Getting better at that. It's really tricky. If you do it wrong, you can mess things up. And see the color of the water. All right, here's my palette. Let's take a look at my palette. So everything here, except for that gray, I didn't use that. I didn't use that green. I didn't use that either. I think everything else I used, yeah. So let's take a look at that. There's my darkest blue. And this is the same. Here's those Prussian blues. And then we get into my lighter lavender blues and stuff. Here's some pinks. And the yellows and the ochres. Right. And then the grays, there's that plum. Here's that turquoise. There's that khaki gray. And then the white and the oil stick. So there, you can see all these values here, all these colors. So I got 1 cent, 2 cents, 3 cents. And if you want to count that. And then the rest is Neo Pastels and Mungios. So that is the palette to this painting. All right. Well, this is my first video on YouTube. I hope it was enjoyable for you guys. Hope you learned something. I really would love it if you had some questions, maybe, comments, things to say. I like getting feedback. I like the engagement. So please comment or like it or whatever. Tell your friends, anyone who's interested in using oil pastels, this is one way of doing it. There's other ways I've done oil pastel. This is one of the ways I'm doing it now. I really enjoy it. It's a layering process. So now I'm done. I'm going to get away from it for a day or so, come back, look at it tomorrow. I don't think I'm gonna change it much. I think I'm done with this. But sometimes it's good to see things with fresh eyes. And then I'll sign it, and then I'm gonna let it sit out for a good week. Let the oil pastel set up a little bit. And then at that point, I will either spray it with a fixative, a final fixative, or I will wrap it in glassine paper and store it. And then make sure I get good pictures of it and stuff. And so yeah, that's it. That's my process. This is one way I do it. I hope to make more of these videos. I hope it's helpful. So please subscribe, comment, like, share, engage with me. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll see you next time.